That's for sure. That's all the sport, Geoff.
Greg, congratulations from us all on the arrival of young Alexander William Robson at the Woden Hospital yesterday. And, of course, to be fair, the real congratulations are due to Jenny. Either way, she and Alexander are fit and well in Woden Valley Hospital today. I'm told Alexander weighs in at 6 pounds, 11 ounces. The flowers are from us all here at Capital Television, and, in fact, from all your viewers, too. Best wishes, mate.
So you want to do the weather next?
I think we should. Here's Michael Larkan with the weather.
I feel really out of it. I've got no babies to talk about that I know of anyway. Not a bad sort of day today. Tomorrow a fraction warm-up with the chance of a late shower. At 6 o'clock in town, the temperature 25 degrees. The winds from the northwest at 2 kilometres per hour. And that barometric pressure 1,009 hectopascals and falling. To the map of New South Wales, and some rain fell along the north coast and northern tablelands. 2 millimetres at Armidale was the top 9-3 reading. The hot spot 36 at Coleraine-Bray, and the cold one 5 at Thredbo. To finish the working week across the nation, and it was mainly fine, with temperatures ranging from 29 degrees in Darwin to 16 in Hobart. The satellite picture and cloud over southern Western Australia has triggered off some patchy rain, and as per normal for summer, a lot of tropical activity is evident in the north. Today's synoptic chart and the high pressure system starting to develop out in the South Tasman Sea is generating that northeasterly airflow. Therefore, the temperature is on the up and up, but unfortunately there is more moisture coming into the region. Tomorrow's chart and very little change with that high moving eastwards, but very slowly. And as I mentioned, there's more of a chance of a late shower with a bit more moisture feeding into the area. Lows over the northern part of Australia, which is normal for this time of year. For the final day of 88 around the nation, just 18 degrees in Hobart, 28 for Brisbane, Sydney and Melbourne, 25. Forecast now for the southern tablelands, some local morning fog patches lifting to a mild to warm day with lengthy sunny periods, local afternoon thunderstorms to conclude a wetter than usual year. Could be the go, light to moderate northeasterly winds, Cooma and Goulburn the mid-20s for the beginning of 89, warm to very warm and humid with local afternoon thunderstorms. The south coast, very similar indeed, though winds will tend southeast to northeasterly. For Sunday and Monday, warm with a few showers. Now for the last day of the bicentennial year in the ACT, fine apart from the chance of a late shower or storm, light winds tending gusty easterly briefly later in the day, the probability of rain increasing to 40% late tomorrow, but the whisper is that it will not be raining at midnight. Winds on the lakes about 15 kilometres per hour, 14 to 27 the temperature range, and for the new year, little change, which sounds very much like my wallet. And now to the world weather, and when you check the minimums and maximums today, spare a thought for the Russians. In Moscow, the temperature ranged from minus 21 to minus 10 degrees. See you in 89, and don't forget that New Year's resolution. What will yours be, Geoff?
I'm not telling. Thank you, Michael. That's it for now, and really from the three of us for this year. So a very happy New Year to all of us and to all of you. And let's have a look at, for one last time, at some of the scenes of 1988.
Goodbye.
Not too late.